Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Oppmann. MTSU takes safety seriously, so much so that we've invested in a full-time accredited police department that makes campus safety our number one priority. Now, using cutting-edge tools like a computer network of video cameras and the old-fashioned ways like building better relationships with our students, we've earned notice as one of the safest large university campuses in the country. Police Chief Buddy Peaster joins us today to discuss all of this and more. Welcome to Out of the Blue, Chief.
Oh, thank you, Andrew. I appreciate your asking me to be here.
So let's talk about your department. I don't think it's widely known to newcomers that we have a full accredited police department serving this campus, almost like a department that would serve a small city, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I think, number one, a lot of people don't realize that campus policing has become a profession unto itself. We have really made it a point over the last decade or so to focus on professionalism, on developing the people who come in. We're very strict about who we hire and bring in, and so I think our department looks a lot different than it did from years past.
One of the things that I know you've taken great pride in, and I have too, is that the effective relationships that the police department's built, and the simplest of things, showing up to events and riding bicycles on campus, and that builds a relationship, right? And that helps you. How does that work?
Well, I think, number one, we don't have an environment that is full of violence. One of the ways that we maintain that is by hiring and helping our officers, our employees, recognize that they're people too, and that they're working in a very diverse environment. And so the people that we have really recognize and respect that and realize that that's part of what makes this a great place. So that makes us, for some people, a different type of police department. Yes, we enforce laws. Yes, we arrest people and take them to jail for violating the law, but there's also a service component that's just as important to us because we feel like it takes both of those areas for us to be very good at, very professional at, in order for us to maintain and help work with people within the community and to keep this a great place to be.
You work really effectively with the Murfreesboro Police Department and the Rutherford County Sheriff's Office. That bond of professionalism and the cohesion of the different departments helps everybody, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Carl Durr at Murfreesboro PD, he's pretty new still. And Mike Fitzhugh at Rutherford County Sheriff's Office, he's real new as well. We work with those folks in some of our extra events on our campus, and we've been of assistance to them just like they have been to us. And I think from a law enforcement perspective and from a community perspective, it takes that. It takes very good people, not just at the top who are your leaders, but it takes people throughout your organization that are willing to work together, share information, look out for the community good. And I think that just has gotten even better with the addition of those two men at the helm of their respective agencies.
There's also a lot of other great new forms of technology that you've got in place here on campus. We have a network of about 400 cameras that are connected by computer that really allow you to extend your enforcement, and I think we've got plans for about 100 more. Talk about how that all connects to the old days of just basically walking a beat or driving a car. You're actually able to be more places, more times, more often, and really be on top of things, right?
Yes, some of the newer stuff with some of the video cameras that we've been able to install as a university over the past couple of 3 years is really starting to help us with a lot of follow-up with some of our criminal cases. But not only that, it's helped us in some civil issues and matters as well. We know that the importance of that video data comes to light when we have people that come to us with information. And it's amazing, not one time when we've sent out pictures of people that we need information about has our community or even people in the city not responded and given us some information that has helped us.
Universities are about learning and about education. And one of the things I know you've also invested in is making sure that the campus has access to safety information. Talk a little bit about what's out there for me as a student or a faculty member or a staff member? Where do I need to go and what do I need to take advantage of?
Well, there's several different sort of alerting or notification programs that the university has. It starts with our alerts that we utilize we have a system that's rave safety. If we have a situation on campus, we immediately send out information there. We collect data and information from police reports and incidents that are reported to us. And for some of those, we will send out notifications where we've experienced something going on campus and we want the community to know about it because it could impact them in the near future. Plus, as you mentioned, information on our website, we connect to the MTSU's Alert for You website. And so we've got a lot of information out there. Some of it we push out in the way notifications, and some of it, you know, we need people to actually go and find out. But we do programs throughout the year to help people know about all of these opportunities. And we give people who are students, faculty, staff, the opportunity to opt in to text messaging, to opt in to phone calls, and those kinds of things. We're on Instagram, we're on Snapchat, Twitter, and Facebook. And so there's lots of platforms, but those are the ones that we use and push out interesting information as well as headline stuff and a lot of things.
If you could, just a few really quick tips on, you know, what are the things that I need to do to keep myself safe?
Okay, well, number one, I think you sort of hit on it. It's great to have wonderful people working for your police department, and I think we do. But you've got to have people within your community as well to at least let us know if they see or hear something, and that they're willing to think about what they can do to keep themselves safe as well. So it takes all of us working together. The number one most important thing that you can do is something that I can say in three words: lock your doors. It's not even starting with any barrier at all, and starting to lock your doors, your car doors, your apartment doors, your residence hall doors. Just lock those things and be mindful of who comes in and out of your house, your apartment, your residence hall room, who you let borrow your car or your equipment or whatever. And secondly is just keeping your stuff with you, being mindful about what you're doing with your information, not leaving it out there, is just as critical as locking your door, as avoiding walking down that dark alleyway or something like that. If you're going somewhere, think about it beforehand. You still need to think about where you're going and have a good plan of getting there safely and getting back safely. That's so important. And to help with that on campus, we have a walking escort service where we'll come and walk with you from one place on campus to another. Those are just some of the very beginning basic things. And I guess the last I would just end with, please call us. We would rather you call us and it be nothing than you be experiencing something that could be dangerous. Well, I just urge people to give us a call. We're there 24/7.
Well, Chief, thanks for joining us on Out of the Blue. And this does wrap up another edition of our program. You can find more stories and videos about the campus 24 hours a day by visiting our website, mtsunews.com. And we invite you to follow MTSU on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for additional special content. I'm Andrew Oppmann, and I hope you will always remain true blue.